Let's learn about event handling in a GUI program. Till now, we have learned how to put various components like button, text fields, list box, etc. in a GUI. Now, we will learn how some action can be taken when the user does something with these components, like clicking on a button. Here, we see a broader picture of what happens when an event occurs. So, in a GUI, let's say there is a component called as a button, and let's say user clicks on this button. We say an event has occurred. The occurrence of the event results in execution of a piece of code, which is responsible for taking some action associated with the event. So, for example, in a GUI form, user has entered a lot of information and then clicked on the button. And as an action, you want to verify whether that information entered is correct or incorrect. This action can be written inside the piece of code. The other thing that may happen is that the appearance of that component will change so that the user knows that the action has been registered. Let's now see how in Java AWT events are handled. This is done by using event delegation model. And this starts by preparing the program by following few steps. So first step that we follow is create an event source. Event source is that GUI component with which some event can occur. So let's say we are interested in an event called as clicking of a button. So then in that case, button becomes the event source. The second thing that we have to do is find the listener of our interest and then register that listener with the event source. And third thing that we have to do in our program is to write a Java method, which will be that piece of code which when executed handles the event or takes an action associated with that event. This we call as the event handler. Once the program is written following these three steps, we are ready to execute the program. So let's say the program executes and then some user action occurs. So user action, let's say that occurs is clicking on the button. This results in triggering of an event, which is noted by the event source. And this event is notified to the event listener. Along with that, there is an event object created. In Java AWT, we have lot of event classes. And one of the event class object would be created that would depend upon which listener you are using. This event object contains the information about the event. So for example, what happened with the button, which button was clicked. Let's say in a GUI form you have 2-3 buttons and you want to know which particular button was clicked. All that information would be there with this event object. So this event object contains all the information and this is also made available to the listener object. Then the listener object is responsible for invoking the event handler. This event object is subsequently passed to the event handler. So as a programmer, in the event handler, I would have all the information about the event because I also have the event object along with me. And then I can take the necessary action. To understand this better, let's look at a program where we are going to create 3 buttons. We'll also create 1 label. The buttons would be associated with 3 colors, red, green, and blue. And clicking of the button would result in that color being filled in a label. So let's see how we write that program. We do imports at the top. So java.awt we would require for creating the components. Applet we would require for creating the applet as a container. And all the event handling related classes, listeners, etc. and the event classes, all of them are available in a package java.awt.event. That is why this import is required. Next, we have an applet tag. We create a class button demo that extends the applet because applet is a container here. And it implements action listener. Here we are using a particular type of listener called as action listener because we are interested in clicking or pressing of the button, and that is noted by the listener called as action listener. Subsequently, you'll learn about many other listeners. This is an interface, as it is obvious through the code. And then inside the program, inside this class, we will start by declaring the GUI components. RBTN, GBTN and BBTN, these are the event sources. Along with the event sources, we also need a label. Within init method, then you start instantiating. So we instantiate RBTN, GBTN and BBTN. That is, we create them. We also create a label. After that, we register the event listener with the event source. So with RBTN, we use a method called as addActionListener. Okay. Reason is because we are implementing ActionListener, we must also register ActionListener. And as a parameter here, we have to pass reference to EventListener. Okay. So now this buttonDemo class is already implementing the ActionListener. buttonDemo class is already implementing the ActionListener. Therefore, if I pass this reference, okay, it would all automatically become reference to the event listener. After you add the action listener with each of the event sources, the final step is to add these components to the container, that is to the applet. Next, we write the event handler. The event handler is also available in the interface. So, interface that we are using here, or the listener that we are using here, is action listener. In this action listener interface, there is a method called as action perform. buttonDemo class is implementing action listener, and therefore buttonDemo class must provide a definition of action perform. Action perform method is defined like this, doesn't return anything, has to be public because it is coming from an interface. And as an argument, it takes an object of event class. So because we are using action listener, the event class also is going to be action event. As told previously, this action event object E will contain all the information about the event. So here in this program, you see that there are three buttons that are there. So which button was clicked, that information would be there with this object. We can get this information out by using getSource method. GetSource method is available through this action event class and gives me the source of the event, gives me the event source information. Now this getSource method returns an object of object class. And that is why I need to typecast it. I need to typecast it to a button because we have three buttons in the program. This, after typecasting, we store this information in B. So now after doing all this, what we have is that which button got clicked, this information is there in B. And now the steps that are remaining to be written is one if-else if structure where we compare what B is. So if B is equal to RBTN, that means red button was clicked, and we change the background color of the label to color.red. We repeat similar steps with green button and blue button. So this is how it will appear when the green button is clicked. You see that the label background has changed to green. So let's summarize all of this. First thing we understand is what an event is. Event describes a state change in an event source. Or other way of viewing it is that it is generated as a consequence of a person interacting with the components in a GUI. So pressing of a button, okay, entering a character through a keyboard, there is a list of items and you select a particular list, or you click with a mouse somewhere. These are various events that may occur which we may be interested in. Apart from that, there are other events which are not directly associated with the GUI component. For example, you can set up a timer. And when the timer expires, an event occurs. Or you can set up a counter, and when a counter exceeds its value, for example, a counter is counting up to 10,000, and when 10,000 is reached, the event occurs. So we may also be interested in such events. Event source is the object that generates an event. So we already have seen button. We can have list box, checkbox, radio buttons. Event sources can also be containers like frame, window, applet. Event listener is an object that is notified when an event occurs. So in the program, we used an event listener called as action listener. It has two major requirements. First is that it must have been registered. So we register it by using that add method. In the program, we used add action listener method for registering. And the second thing that the second requirement that this event listener has is that it must implement the method, okay, to receive and process the events. So this is the event handler. So in the program, we wrote the method as action performed. And for using event listeners, we use a package java.awt.event. So this is the action listener that we learned. This action listener is an interface and has one method action performed. And this is invoked when some action event occurs. It has only, this method does not return anything. And as an argument, it takes an event class called as action event class. Next is an event handler, a method that processes an event. So in the program, the event handler that we used was action performed. Okay. Declared inside the listener interface. And if a class implements the listener, for example, button demo was implementing the listener, then it should provide definition of all the methods that are declared inside the listener interface. So inside our action listener, there was only one method action performed, and therefore button demo class provided definition only for action performed. But this may not be true for other interfaces. Other interfaces may have multiple methods. Therefore, a class when implements the listener interface must provide a definition of all the methods that are there inside the listener. Then we have the event classes. So in the program, the event class that we used was action event. Okay. It represents the event in a program, and an object of this event class is created when the event occurs. And this object contains a lot of information about the event. For example, which button was pressed, location at which the mouse was clicked, which key was pressed, and so on.